This group was here last year, so it's a unique group. They came a long ways. And last year, when I first started being around these guys, they wasn't close. And I've never been on the secondary or been a part of a secondary that wasn't close. I've been on top secondaries in the country, in college here at UCF, and I've been on top secondaries in the National Football League. I know what it takes to be the good secondary, and it's not about everybody running a 4-3 and a 40. It's not about that. You need guys that are able to trust each other, able to compete on a daily basis, able to be close, hang with each other off the field, come watch film with each other and be close.
You know, as the years go on, you know, we got so much closer, you know, and I can really say that they are my brothers, you know. This is someone I can count on, you know. When this football is all over, you know, these are people that I still will be around, you know, and definitely keep in touch with, you know, and make it so much easier to play with these guys, because I feel like there's some things that I think that they already know I'm thinking, you know, and that's the, feel like that's the bond that we created over the years, you know, playing with each other, you know. Coming from, you know, everybody in this group was second string at one point, you know, playing behind guys, and now is our time, we all starting together. So, I know I feel like that's a big difference, you know. We've been staying with each other since we got here.
It's a passionate thing about us, like all of us being here 4-5 years, like we know each other, like we hang out, we go out with each other, do everything together. So like our bond, it's so close, and like we motivate each other, like we always competing, and like this summer workout, we'll compete so much, like, you know, people would get mad, but we, at the end of the day, we're a team, we're a brotherhood, and like we always stick together.
He looks downfield, rim comes, throws the pass downfield, it's gonna be tipped in the air, and is it intercepted? It is, by Shaquille Griffin. What an interception at the 11-yard line.
Wow.
I feel like all the DBs bring something different. I know Murchison, he's very passionate about it. You know, and DJ, he has his own technique. He's very smart with the game. You know, with me, I enjoy, you know, I'm the one that have fun. I'm the one that make all the jokes, you know, and Draco is the one that keep everything together. You know, I feel like with everybody playing their own different role, it makes something great in that back unit.
I like the different personalities. I think that when you're in a group setting, you know, they're in their defensive backs meeting, they're in their drills, they're in the defensive unit meeting. I think that's really cool when guys come from different backgrounds, different personalities. That way, you know, when they leave here to go in the real world, if you will, they're not used to showing up to their job, and everybody's not exactly like them. You know, they know how to adapt to a different environment. They know how to get along with other people. They think that, you know, a guy might be from Miami, another guy from the Panhandle. It's a different world, but they might say, hey, man, he likes that. That's pretty cool. I like this. That's pretty cool. You know, maybe I should get into what he's getting into, and maybe, you know, he should do the same. And I think they grow as people when there's a different mindset in every room.
After retiring from football, and I gave myself a year to, you know, kick back and decide that this is really what I want to do. You know, it has to be something that, if I choose to do it, it has to be something that I can't turn my back on. You know, you have those problems. A lot of guys that play in the National Football League, they just do it just because they feel like they can. But I just want to do it. I want to coach football because this is where my heart was. And so when I got out of football and I came here to UCF, you know, I coached high school ball first just to test it out and see if this is what I wanted to do, and I fell in love with it. You know, I have a family. My family coached football, my brother. So, you know, it's in my family. But when I got in here and started coaching, and it's been awesome experience. I coach from passion, you know, off experience. I ain't the smartest guy in the world. I learn from everybody I probably encounter with on a daily basis. So I'm always steady learning.
Coach Frost got here when I was, you know, finishing up the bowl game and deciding what my future would bring. He told me that he already had a guy that he wanted to retain as a DB coach, and I didn't know him at all. I got down here and we started talking, and I realized he knew, you know, he really knew his stuff. He knew exactly what he wanted to do, and he was a guy that I wanted to be here. I think he does an excellent job recruiting as well as coaching those defensive backs, and they respect him because of, you know, the career he had here and the career he had in the NFL and his overall knowledge of the game.
Man, he's a great coach. He's a hands-on coach. He's more on the field, like, you know, work with your hands-on, tell you what you're doing. Film room, he get on the board. He's a very smart dude. We look up to him a lot. All of us in that room. Like, you know, he don't really talk too much about it, but, like, you know, you go to his office, you see all the footballs, the trophies, and like he'll tell you about it, stuff. But like, you know, he like to see us compete and like, you know, want us to make it to the next level, but you know, you gotta put the work in.
Coach Fish, he loved the game, but he also loves the kids, you know. I feel like he loves his job. You know, as you know, some coaches may do it for the money, and some coaches actually love doing what they do. And I feel like he's one of them coaches. He's one of the coaches who love just helping. And it's so much easier to take tips and different stuff from him, because I know he's there for us. And that makes it so much easier. Not something that people look for. You know, when I came to college, I looked for that family type of environment. And Coach Fisher gives us that. It's not just, I'm just your coach. Or, you know, he treats us like we're family. And, you know, it's easy to play under someone who's like that. You know, we can go to Coach Fisher anytime in his office, not just talk about football, but you can talk about life, period. And a lot of people don't get that from their coaches. And I feel like Coach Fisher brings that to the table. And, you know, and you can see, if you ever came in my DB room, you can see the type of environment we have. You know, it's never too intense. It's just relaxed because we feel comfortable around him, you know, and it's easy to take different tips and different orders from him because we love playing for him. And, you know, and he loves coaching us. So it's so much easier to play that way and play under somebody like that.